Fellow St. Lucians, to have been appointed Chair of the Independence Planning Committee 2021 has been an honor and my pleasure. The coronavirus may rage war against our small nation, but as a people of love and resilience, we persevere. We can and will win this war. This year, the resilience of our nation was discussed and debated, highlighted and promoted in song, dance, and visible displays of that patriotism that resides in us, that love for our simply beautiful St. Lucia. We are a nation replete with talent, and it is our joy as a committee to bring to you each year the new, the upcoming, and the best of our nation. I now take the opportunity to thank and congratulate the team behind the scenes. Deputy Chair of the Independence Committee, members of the Independence Committee, Secretariat staff, constituency councils, the Royal Police Band, National Television Network, NTN, which is the home of Independence, and the media houses of HTS, Hot 7, and DBS. Producers, creative directors, filmmakers and videographers, sound engineers, lighting engineers, graphic artists, caterers, drivers, and our sponsors, Flo, Harry Edwards Jewelers, Digicel, and Massey Stores. Happy Independence, St. Lucians, here at home and in the diaspora, when your thousands tuned into us at home. May God continue to bless us and keep our God-fearing nation safe. We are a resilient nation. We can, we will. Your nation qui résilient, nous a fait, nous kaifé. Good night and thank you for watching.
On behalf of the government of St. Lucia, I want to express my profound gratitude to the Independence Committee under the able leadership of Honorable Janine Girudi McIntyre for the splendid work undertaken to deliver this year's virtual package of programs for our 42nd anniversary of independence celebrations. Over the last few days, our nation witnessed a riveting, captivating, and memorable display of St. Lucian talent, particularly from our young people. And we saw this talent aptly displayed against the backdrop of our country's natural and majestic physical assets and the indefatigable warmth and love of our people. Indeed, at 42, we have much to be proud of. And we must endeavor as a people never to underestimate ourselves, because we can and we will succeed at anything we deem important to us as a nation. This virtual celebration was indeed a classic. That is why my government continues to invest in the creative sector, to capitalize on such occasions and afford young people the opportunity to realize their potential and make their contribution to national development through the arts. The COVID-19 pandemic has tested our resolve in many ways, but we continue to trust God and put Him first, because it is only through Him the vision for our country will unfold in the way it ought to. With the great leadership offered by our Prime Minister, Honorable Alan Michael Chastney, the supportive team of cabinet ministers, our teams at the various ministries, our agencies such as the Cultural Development Foundation, the Events Company of St. Lucia, the private sector, and you, our patriotic and ambitious, vibrant citizens, we must ensure that we stay the course so that our nation can continue to build the resilience required to press on and navigate through the challenges that will always be looming for us to conquer. Again, happy 42nd birthday, St. Lucia, and thank you all at home and abroad for your input and participation in our programming. Remember, we can, we will. Stay safe and let's keep working. Thank you.